In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. It's Friday of the 21st week in ordinary time. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 1, verses 17 to 25. Brethren, Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, and not with eloquent wisdom, lest the cross of Christ be emptied of its power. For the word of the cross is folly to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the cleverness of the clever I will thwart. Where is the wise man? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, it pleased God through the folly of what we preach to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks seek wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and folly to Gentiles. But those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. God, yes. Jesus, yes. Church, no. God, yes. Jesus, yes. Church, no. This kind of thinking is very common today among many. Are we too one among these many? Are we too one among these many? Are there times when we feel that the church's teaching is too conservative, old-fashioned, unreasonable and impractical, and not in line with the modern advances in the sciences, especially regarding morality and family life? Is it possible that we are devout church-going Christians and yet remain quite undisturbed to follow the more practical solution that the wise and intelligent of the world offer? When the doctrine of the church is not to our liking? Yes, the teaching of the church, my dear friends, is a cross at times. But that's because it is not based on any human science or wisdom, but on the life of Christ and Him crucified. Saint Paul plainly tells us the message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved. It is the power of God. It is an undeniable fact that the church is guided by the Holy Spirit, who teaches us everything and reminds us of all that Christ has said to us, just as he promised us. Can it be then that the scientists and thinkers, intellectuals and professionals who support their claim with their seemingly clear and flawless conclusions that what the church upholds in certain matters is impractical, are even wiser than the God who created them? God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Yes, to follow what Mother Church teaches may seem to be foolishness by worldly standards, all because she teaches according to the mind of Christ, who did the most foolish thing by dying on the cross in order to save us sinners. Well then, let us become fools like him. Let us become fools like him. Let us pray. Today, as we find in the Bible diary, my dear friends, Edwin Kutinna from Mangalore celebrates his birthday. We wish him happy birthday and we pray for God's choicest blessings on him. It's also the death anniversary of Stephen William from Honavar. May the Lord grant him eternal rest. Father, give us the grace to have the mind of Christ. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a great Friday, my dear friends. This is Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest, and my WhatsApp number is 9481263229. I repeat, 9481263229. Don't forget to share this audio with your friends and contacts along with the message attached to it. Thank you. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.